to our little, you know, piece of purgatory right here.
Exactly, exactly. We got Jessica with us here today. Hello, hello.
Professor Jessica.
Professor Jessica.
Professor Jessica.
Professor.
Yeah, that's kind of nice.
Drinking a fresca.
And, it's
and
like a drink.
Drinking a fresca, yeah. John Morocco playing the drums.
Hey!
He's officially changed his name to John Morocco.
Morocco tried to sue, but they don't have a chance.
They don't have a chance. Guy Forsyth right there. And I'm Scrappy Judd back from the road.
Yay!
Happy to be here. Oh, thank you. And it's Stephen Bruton's birthday, so we'll kick it off where the song is. From right, there's a lesson that you could learn. Walk by faith, not by sight. When the darkness falls on your brightest day and it turns into an endless night, what could lead you home by a different way? Walk by faith and not by sight. By sight, you come to understand. Not by sight, you reach the promised land. Not by sight, now don't slow your pace. Not by sight, you got to walk by faith. If you stumble and you fall, you might lose your will to fight. But you conquer self, you can conquer all. Walk by faith and not by sight. Never darkness falls and the well run dry. You can't see, but you ain't blind. One more option that you could try. Walk by faith, not by sight. Not by sight, you come to understand. Not by sight, you reach the promised land. Not by sight, now don't slow your pace. Not by sight, you got walk by faith. All right, guys. I spent a long time wandering here and there, just looking for a place to hide. I mistook going for getting somewhere. Walk by faith and not by sight. Looking for a shadow 'cause the sun's too bright. 99 and a half won't do. Don't take the path of least resistance where wrong feels right. Walk by faith, not by sight. Hey, not by sight. Understand, not by sight. You reach the promised land, not by sight. Now don't slow your pace, not by sight. You got to walk by faith. Walk by faith and not by sight.
All right. Thank you so much. That's a Stephen Bruton and Yogi Musgrove composition. We send it out to both of them this morning.
Yeah.
Professka Jessica.
I like the new name. That's fun. Sorry, I have to make my microphone stand longer. Maybe. Or I'll just move it to me so Guy can see Scrappy.
Thank you.
Fun thing about musicians, they like to stare at each other while they're playing.
So Jess is overseeing our broadcast around the world, where we are sending out this positive message everywhere. And you can help because you could share this show with friends that are so unfortunate as to not be here today for free. Mm-hmm. It costs absolutely nothing. But
whoa, free?
Free. I know what you're thinking. You think free. What's wrong with it? No, that's not it.
Free shows.
Because we are raising money for the Central Texas Food Bank, and for every dollar that we raise, for every dollar that we raise, we are able to feed four people. There are QRC codes on the table that if you expose them to the cameras of your smartphones, it will connect you directly with the source, and if you'd like to donate money to the Central Texas Food Bank, you can. It's just that simple. We also, for the good-hearted Luddites among you who are still using paper money, we do have these convenient receptacles to help cleanse your money.
Yeah. Also known as the Cheeto can. The Cheeto puff can.
Drop a buck in there, feed four people.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's pretty amazing.
That's amazing. That's like, I mean, usually I was only able to ever feed that one Pac-Man guy with one quarter. But yeah. And only for a little while.
And only, he's never satisfied.
So this song, perfect segue, y'all. What'd you do?
Just a stranger on the bus, down a
would God do? I also like to think of what would Betty White do or Dolly Parton?
Also, good representations of the Godhead right there. I mean,
God is a she, I believe.
Well, yes. Since it is Stephen's birthday, I'd like to send this song that I wrote with my friend Brian Keene.
Oh, yeah.
And we'd like to send it out to Stephen. I was writing songs with my friend Brian in Nashville, which is not something that happens a whole lot. You know, but there I was, and we were, you know, following the old school approach to getting rich quick in the music industry by writing a song and solving all of your problems, you know, which you could do at any time. You know, like if you just happen to write the right song, you will solve all of your problems. And if that hasn't happened to you, you're just not trying hard enough. So we were trying really hard. We were writing songs in the Nashville style where you don't necessarily have to have anything to say to write a song. All you need is a number two pencil, a legal pad, and a suppressed gag reflex, and you know, you can really get some work done. And so we were writing songs, and for 2 days we just sat, you know, like did nothing else. We wrote 7 songs, and luckily you will never have to hear those songs. No one has to. No one has to. It's just not necessary.
And we appreciate it.
On the third day, we were working on Brian's car as opposed to songs, so it would work, so I could get back to the airport and I could get home. And I got a telephone call, and it was bad news from my friend Carrie Wallum about Stephen Bruton. If you don't know who we're talking about, Stephen Bruton is a great musician that you've probably been listening to your whole life, even if you didn't know his name. He was just one of those guys. If you listen to Kris Kristofferson or Bonnie Raitt on the radio, if it just happens to come on, he's probably the other guitar player. And he was just an amazing guy who made other musicians play better being around him. He was a fierce, uncompromising stand for excellence in musicians. So if you were kind of sleeping on the gig, he'd tell you. And so just made the whole experience better for everyone else because everybody just sat up a little bit straighter and did a little bit better. So I got this telephone call and I hung up the phone and I talked to my friend Brian and we looked at each other and without really any conversation about it, we put down the tools that were working on the car and picked up the guitar and wrote the song in about 15 minutes. It's not always that easy. But sometimes it is, if you're paying attention. So don't forget to pay attention to where you are and what's going on. Sits and watches lovers pass him by.
it matter. I only want things that you can share. Don't give me diamond rings or those so-called finer things. They don't matter when they are not there. So I gave my girl a watch that shined with diamonds, the prettiest watch that you would ever find. And she left it in the drawer when she walked right out my door. Turns out all she needed was my time. I only want the things that matter. I only want things that you can share. Don't give me diamond rings, all those so-called finer things. They don't matter when they are not there. Not a rich man. Expect you know that I'm not a rich man's son. But you should run and play and gather roses while you may. Can't buy your time back when it's done. I only want the things that matter. I only want things that you can share. Don't give me diamond rings, all those so-called finer things. They don't matter when they are not there. Oh, they don't matter when they are not there.
Yeah.
Right. Well, that's
great. That's Guy Forsythe. What a great song that is. And speaking of great, John Morocco's playing drums, and I wonder if we might tickle his fancy to sing a song.
Okay.
Okay. You want to continue the Bruton?
Continue the Bruton.
Power hour.
Oh,
power hour, yeah. Baby.
I feel compelled to say, because I don't think we're conflicting with anything going on here tonight, that we are having kind of a Bruton birthday party at the Resentment Show tonight. So there'll be lots of Stephen Bruton tunes. 7:30.
A lot of them that we do all the time, but yes. There's going to be a whole bunch of stuff that we're pulling out of the archives.
Yes, a lot of them that we used to do.
Yeah,
all the time.
Yeah.
About 12 years ago. Mm-hmm. But yeah, so come on out. And Plank's in town, so it'll be a Brutonathon.
You know, the best musical advice single-handedly I ever got was from Stephen.
And what was that advice?
Well, we were overseas. We were over there in the motherland. And there was this one gig that I couldn't really hear well, and I was struggling with the monitor and with the language barrier with the sound guy not getting it right. And after the gig, Stephen came up to me and goes, "Man, are you all right?" And I said, "Well, yeah, man, what's going on?" He goes, "Well, man, every time I looked at you on stage tonight, you just had this painful look on your face." And I said, well, you know, I couldn't hear, and I was trying to listen to you guys, and I was thinking about all this stuff. He goes, no, wait here. He goes, rule number one, break your give a shitter.
Yes.
And I said, what? He goes, just play. Just play and don't do anything else.
Right.
Best advice I ever got.
It is.
Buzzy was a little kid. He used to play down in his basement. He hollered, I'm a human rocket, gonna be an outer spaceman. So he got a little ladder, raised it up against a limb. Was no great step for mankind, but it was off of it for him. Just a step, one small step, leap of faith and a resurrection. Just a step, one small step in the right direction. She had her thumb out on the highway. There was nothing left for Sue to do. And big sunglasses couldn't cover up the black and blue. She did not know where she was going, but standing still was suicide. Now the only thing she'd taken is the one thing she never tried. Just a step, one small step, leap of faith and a resurrection. Just a step, one small step in the right direction. Scrappying guy, y'all. Some say life's a bed of roses, others wear it like a crown of thorns. I used to die just to get to heaven. Now I'm too busy being born. Just a step, one small step, leap of faith and a resurrection. Just a step, one small step, one small step in the right direction. Just a step, one small step, leap of faith and a resurrection. Step, one small step. that direction.
Johnny Morocco. Yeah, it's fun. I was on the road and had a day off in Asheville, and I spent it with Johnny's old bandmate Ed Jurdy from the band of Heathens over there, and it was really great. We'd had this whole day walking around and went up in the wilderness, and anytime your name came up or anything with resentments, it was just Morocco. Yeah, Morocco. That's what I was just like. It's just the name has just taken such firm hold.
I have you to thank for that, Scrappy.
I know. But it's just, I never really experienced like a normal, casual conversation and somebody in all seriousness. Well, you know, man, like Morocco, man, he's got this, you know, just like.
I keep trying to find him on Instagram under Johnny Morocco.
Yeah. The legend.
Chipman.
It actually is on Instagram, though, but it's spelled differently because it was already.
Johnny Morocco was taken?
Yeah. I'm going to find him and kick his butt.
People want to be Johnny Morocco.
Yeah.
I do.
It's just the way it is.
He does. Oh,
if they only knew.
But you do file your taxes under that name, yeah, which is great.
Such as they are, yeah.
It's actually John J. Morocco.
John J. Morocco, yeah. Just like on the...
What's the J for?
It's just the letter. It's actually just the letter. Yeah.
I think that's me. Every time I move, you're squeaming.
On a building, I'm working on a building, I'm working on a building for my Lord, it's a Holy Ghost building, it's a Holy Ghost building, it's a Holy Ghost building for my Lord, for my If I was a gambler, I'd tell you what I might do. Cut out all my gambling ways, start working on a building too. I'm working on a building. I'm working on a building. I'm working on a building for my Lord. It's a Holy Ghost building, yeah. It's a Holy Ghost building. It's a Holy Ghost building for my Lord, for my Lord. Well, if I was a rounder, I tell you what I could do. I could cut out all my rambling ways and start working on a building too. I'm working on a building. I'm working on a building. I'm working on a building for my Lord, for my Lord. It's a Holy Ghost building. It's a Holy Ghost building. It's a Holy Ghost building for my Lord, for my Lord.
All right, guys. Thank you. to work we go. Hi-ho, hi-ho, it's off to work we go. I'm working on a building. I'm working on a building. I'm working on a building for my Lord, for my Lord. It's a Holy Ghost building. It's a Holy Ghost building. It's a Holy Ghost building for my Lord, for my Lord. Yeah. It's for my Lord, for my Lord. Thank you so much.
Do you think that building's going to stand up? Or I'm not sure. It doesn't seem to be level.
There was a lot of sound coming off that
I don't know why I'm giving you feedback, but I am.
It's important to get feedback in life.
I mean, yes, I like feedback, but not screechy feedback. Constructive feedback.
Constructive feedback, please.
You can see I'm a busybody up here. I'm running the live stream. If you have people that might want to watch, you can go to the Purgatory Players on Facebook. You can also go on YouTube under Guy Forsythe Band. Sometimes Facebook likes to shut us down for songs we wrote ourselves. And so if that happens, you can find us and still keep watching on YouTube. And if you're at home, you have the QR code right there on your screen for your convenience. Oh, I have to give him a saw. 1 second, Guy Banter.
Hi, I'm Guy Forsythe. I play Guy Forsythe on TV and in real life. If you're watching this on TV right now, you know that's true.
It is.
Because I'm always right and I never lie.
He is wrong.
So remember to tip that bartender, tip that waitress, as if your soul depended on it, because
it does.
It does.
And I'd love an iced tea.
This is a.
There she is.
She's the best.
Thank you, Sam.
This is Widow's Peak. I'm not sure. Makes a noise for our staff. Amazing. Yeah. So in Europe, I think that it's in Ireland. There's a cliff that overlooks the ocean, and you can see the lighthouse there. And it's called Widow's Peak. And for hundreds of years, women would go there and wait for the ships to return, you know, before internet and cell phones. And it's called Widow's Peak because, you know, they didn't ever know if their loved one was coming back or not. So,
yes.
Happy Sunday.
Beautiful. Professka Jeska, everybody.
Yeah.
Any grandparents here? Anybody that suspects they just might be grandparents? It's also a possibility. Yeah, it's an option. So, this is a J.B. Lenore song.
Oh, yeah.
I'd better not be here.
Well, this is our way of telling you something today. Boys, come on in here. Let's show up little Roger.
Well, my grandma told me what good advice. What my grandma told me was good advice. What my grandma told me was good advice. She said, yeah, keep on going if you're sure you're right. And you sweat and you strain. Your name will ramble. Wise man bet, a fool he gambled. Barking dogs hardly bite. Was gone in the dark, will be brought to the light. Can't tell a farmer from a lover. Can't judge a book just looking at the cover. Grandma told me what good advice. What my grandma told me was good advice. What my grandma told me was good advice. She said, yeah, keep on going if you're sure you're right. Thank you.
but very few go. You know the rest of the night, just before day, cause when the cat is gone, the mice, he was surely play. Grandma told me what good advice, what my grandma told me what good advice, what my grandma told me what good advice. She said, you keep on going if you're sure.
I see a few people. I think we're going to have some action-packed guests.
Mm-hmm. Goody.
Some guest behavior in the second set. We're going to do another song and take a quick break. But priority number one, primary reason for being here is to raise some money for the Central Texas Food Bank. So, as has been pointed out, you've got the digital means, you've got the pickle bucket means, and what else do you need?
If you're on a budget, you could just chant.
Yeah.
It's also good.
Credit card.
It's also good.
Yeah. And a buck, you know. If you got a buck to spare, it's like when we say feed four people, that's four meals, you know, four square meals and this full spectrum of nutritional
hard to believe that in such a thriving area as Austin, Texas, that food insecurity is an absolute issue and at the top of some people's lives, the one thing, which historically is what humans have done. You know, that has been the human experience all through history, but right now it's just hard to imagine with all the high rises and stuff going up in Austin that it's a problem, but it sure is.
If you look at the pamphlet on your table, you can go to the QR code and not only just use it to donate, but you can also go directly to the Purgatory Players donation page and see where we are on our little bar graph of our goal. And I think that we're still about 5,000 away from our goal because this year's been a little slow, the pandemic. So share it. Share it wherever you can.
And don't forget the gospel turkey is looming on the horizon. His dark form is, is off in the distance,
gobble,
coming ever
gobble,
closer.
Gobble, gobble.
Jesus a long time.
I'm not tired yet.
I've been running for Jesus a long, long time.
I'm not tired yet.
I've been running for Jesus a long time.
I'm not tired yet.
I say, oh, good God Almighty, I'm not tired yet. I've been working for Jesus a long time.
I'm not tired yet.
I've been working for Jesus a long, long time.
I'm not tired yet.
Hey, I've been working for Jesus a long time.
I'm not tired yet.
I say, oh, good God Almighty, I'm not tired yet. All right, guys.
Going, man.
Jesus a long time.
I'm not tired yet.
I've been walking for Jesus a long, long time.
I'm not tired yet.
Well, well, I've been walking for Jesus a long time.
I'm not tired yet.
I say, oh, good God Almighty, I'm not tired yet. I've been singing for Jesus a long time.
I'm not tired yet.
Singing for Jesus a long, long time.
I'm not tired yet.
Well, 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 been singing for Jesus a long time.
I'm not tired yet.
I say, oh, good God Almighty, I'm not tired yet. A long time.
I'm not tired yet.
I've been running for Jesus a long, long time.
I'm not tired yet.
I've been working for Jesus a long time.
I'm not tired yet.
I say, oh, good God Almighty, I'm not tired yet. Well, I've been running and running and running and running.
I'm not tired yet.
I've been running. Been working, 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 working.
I'm not tired yet.
I say, oh, good God Almighty, I'm not tired yet. I've been walking, 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 walking.
I'm not tired yet.
I've been walking, 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 walking.
I'm not tired yet.
Woo! I've been singing and singing and singing and singing.
I'm not tired yet.
I say, oh.
Hey, we'll be right back, y'all, with all kinds of fun, so don't go anywhere.
Yeah, I got it. Give them Father for they know. What she feels, what she feels is important to you.
Right.
Huh?
Yeah.
Why?
Because I want to still love me, but I know she still like me because, you know, a little eye contact at because I don't know her no more, but.
Oh, you talking about somebody. You told me.
When all the dark clouds roll away, young sun begins to shine. I see my
troubled water. Look at those babies dressed in red. God's gonna trouble the water. Oh, they must have been a babies Moses led. God's gonna trouble the water. Wait in the water. Wait in the water, children. Wait in the water. God's gonna trouble the water. Gonna trouble the water. He said, look out, lady, you're heading for hell. God's gonna trouble the water. I said, wait in the water. Wait in the water, children. Wait in the water. God's gonna trouble the water. Gonna trouble the water. Oh, nobody there, turn me out. God's gonna trouble the water. I said, wait in the water. Wait in the water, children. Wait in the water. God's gonna trouble the water. I said, gonna trouble the water. I said, God's gonna trouble the water.
Yeah. We're going to start the moseying process. Get the show back on the road. And we got our friend, yes? Oh, John Morocco has no sound. John Morocco. John Morocco.
And guess what, Scrappy?
What is it?
So last week, my good friend Rob, the swarthy bearded gentleman back there, very handsome fellow.
Right.
He's an amazing photographer, and he's got a calendar of Town Lake, and they're amazing.
Right.
So last week he came out and put a bunch of the calendars over here, and 100% of the profit of those calendars go to the food bank.
Really?
And last week he gave out five of them. They're $20 each. The photographs are amazing. So there's three of them over there, and
nice.
And they got snatched up in like 5 seconds.
Yeah.
So there's three left at $20, and all the money goes to the food bank. Rob's over there. If he runs out there, you can still buy them from him afterwards.
Rob.
So yeah. Thanks, Rob.
Yep. And this will prove to yourself that you're someone who has it together, because I unfortunately usually get around to calendar shopping in February.
Exactly. So you get a jump on it.
You can get some deals.
Yeah, exactly. Man, you wait till July. You wouldn't believe how. But we got our friend Amy from the food bank here. She's going to talk to you. Please listen.
Hi, everybody. Oh, a participative group. I like that. Thanks for being here today. I wanted to let you know, and Scrappy, I don't know if you know this, but there's a doubling match right now, a matching donor, the Beaumont Foundation. So right now, every dollar is actually 8 meals.
Ah, holy moly.
Yeah. And that'll go through the end of the year. So any donations that you're making, they're doubling them automatically.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And then there's another anonymous donor for our Gospel Turkey event who is going to match up to $2,000. So that's something to maybe, you know, rifle through the couch cushions and see what you can come up with. Yeah.
The Gospel Turkey is the Sunday before Thanksgiving.
It is to be beholden.
And it's something, it's kind of generally been our biggest show of the year. I'm not sure if the mascot will be here or not. He might be here virtually. He may be here in person.
I have faith.
Yeah. He has a, he's a
gospel turkey.
It's a giant gospel turkey who dances the robot while we play. And the but we have a lot of guests. We really just pour it on and try. We just play straight through, and it's just a big. There's really no telling who's going to show up. We've had all kinds of crazy special guests drop in over the years. Lady Gaga, and. And obviously we're, you know, Thanksgiving is we're entering a time where the food bank, which is already stressed, is getting to a real point where they get a lot of people needing food. So, and Amy can tell you more about that.
Yeah. So the Sunday before Thanksgiving, if you can't be here personally, definitely tune in on Facebook or some of the other social media places that Jessica's got set up. You can donate virtually. You can be here in person. It's going to be a great event. It's been a great event every year that I've been here to to witness it. So whatever you can give, the food bank really does depend on it, particularly for the holidays. There are a lot of people who don't have, you know, the basics to be able to celebrate togetherness and family with their loved ones. So being able to go to the food bank and get some of the traditional foods is really good. A couple of other things I wanted to tell you about, the money that you donate. One of the things, one of the programs that it contributes to is a culinary program. And if you've never been down to the food bank, I encourage you to go down just for a tour, or if you want to go donate your time for a two-hour shift. But check out their commercial kitchen. It's really amazing. It's world-class. They've got a potato peeling machine, which, I mean, who amongst us wouldn't like one of those?
I want to do that.
Yeah, yeah. But it's got a blast chiller. It's got all sorts of really cool commercial kitchen equipment that's important for food safety, because they do prepare meals for, you know, the elderly and perhaps people who are not in great immune, you know, maybe immunocompromised. So they have to be sure time and temperature is really respected. And in this culinary program, they actually, it's free, and they teach people how to be culinary professionals. And so there are some qualifications for the program. You have to be either formerly incarcerated or living in a homeless shelter or in permanent housing. You need to qualify for income levels so that they're really making sure to target it to people who need a help pull up, right? So they can become sustainable and financially sustainable for themselves. It gives the basics of, you know, knife skills, how to use all the equipment so they can go work at a big hotel or a commercial kitchen where they're equipped to jump in and start earning money. It's free to the participants. Right now they're limiting it to just 4 people per cohort because of COVID. But they've just graduated their 9th cohort, which is fantastic. That means there's people out in the community that are now equipped to, you know, fend for themselves. So it's really a great program. That's just one of the many programs the food bank offers, but I encourage you to go down there and check everything out. I've got some flyers over here if you want to see the different ways you can donate. And I've also got some swag, so feel free to come over. But thanks for being here today.
Yes. Thank you, Amy.
8 meals.
Yeah, and I would definitely second that. I know it does sound maybe a little unusual to go, oh, man, you ought to go to the food bank and check it out. But it's a really cool facility. And it's just amazing to see what, with some organization and some funding, and how effective something like that can be put together. And speaking of effective, ladies and gentlemen, Austin's word woman, Kate Howard, she's right here. She's got something special for you.
All right. Speaking of effective, one of the things that I subscribe to is that kindness is efficient. Yes. So they say that the squeaky wheel gets the grease. But, you know, if you're nice and you're conscientious, you're going to grease your wheels by yourself. You won't need somebody to grease them for you. And it's not why I'm nice. You know, it's certainly people could read, you know, people can tell when you're being disingenuous. So, but yeah, kindness is efficient. You go to the airport, people are nicer to you if you're nice. You know, anywhere, here, for example. And I'm so grateful to be on this stage. Thank you so much for inviting me.
Of course.
Always. We love you.
Always.
So now I'm going to do a song about voodoo. My alter ego. We had dreams, we had plans. He took off with another man. What's a woman to do? To his face I wished him well. Behind his back said, go to hell. Think I'm gonna take a
Howard, everybody.
Thank you very much.
Let that be a lesson to you.
Yes. Yeah. So awesome, that's Kate. My alter ego. That song's called Good Luck Southern Style. It's on my debut CD, which is called The Best Medicine. And I'm going to be playing a show on the 18th, which is a Thursday. It's an early show. It's 7 to 9. And it's at New World Deli, and Kevin McKinney from Soul Hat will be my guest.
Right on.
So come on out.
Very good.
Thank you so much.
Kate. Thank you, Kate.
Shana.
Come here, thank you.
Got a lot of strings on that guitar.
Yeah, I keep showing up with a different one, huh? So this is an original.
Oh, nice.
Maybe I should plug it in. I haven't played an original.
I think we'd all listen, even if you weren't plugged in.
Thank you.
Beneath my feet, blades of grass scattered round dandelion petals. I tried not to crush them as I ventured toward another awkward rebel. She was in my favorite spot on the banks of the Colorado River. A stone's throw from the trash cans with the bums getting clever. Said the path's just a circle round the sun going round, down, up again. Daffodils drives an old galaxy flying off the hills, yellow dashes flowing in a black beaded river under the swirling sky. I tried to capture back at dawn, a joyful party at the same time a disaster, craving the whole picture, yearning like the masters, going round, going round, going round.
Sorry, it's so random.
Crazy circle. Now I can be home again behind these windows. Share my visions, travel far and wide. Never leave and always keep her love inside.
Shana, that was great.
Shana, that was great.
Where are you playing then?
It was the Trail Foundation is doing some a thing on November 13th. I'm playing at a park. That should be fun.
Yeah.
Is that next to the power station?
I have to find the location still.
Okay.
ShanaSands.com.
There you go. Yeah, that's the only one that I have planned coming up. So,
all right.
We'll let you know.
So well, she's available for hire.
Yeah, book some more quick.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm sorry it was hard.
No, it was great.
That was great.
I
think Stacey Bell, are you ready?
Yeah. I believe she is.
This is Stacey Bell. One of our new converts to Gospel Brunch.
We should also point out that Lady D is running our mercantile over there. Lady D. She's a wonderful conversationalist. If you don't want to buy anything, just go talk to her.
I'm guessing we don't have a music stand up here.
No, there's not, but I could run and get you one. You want me to get one for you?
There's one right over there.
I'll just get it for you.
Oh, thank you so much.
You're welcome. Hi, y'all.
Howdy.
My name is Stacey Bell. That's S-T-A-C-3-Y. The three is silent. All right, so get situated here.
Situated.
I mentioned this last time. I'm not used to playing while sitting down. So I got to kind of adjust a little bit. This is 1/4-5 in G,
nice.
And it's 3/4 time.
I love it.
So this song is a true story, and I'm sure all you ladies have experienced this in the past. When you go to some place like the Broken Spoke, there are lots of kind of pro dancers there, and they'll come up and ask you to dance. Well, they always say, you know, I say, don't, no, I can't, I'm not going to dance, can't do it. And then they say, oh, I can teach you. Yeah, well, they usually make it about halfway around the floor before depositing me back in my seat. So this song is about that, and it's called Broken Spoke. Oh, I'm not plugged in. That would be bad.
Right. It's okay, we're all doing it. The popular thing to do.
I usually play this with a fiddle player and a lap steel guy, so it's gonna sound a little weird to me.
Make bell noises.
Watching Boo, he was shuffling across this old dance floor in the dirty old mirror. Behind this dirty old bar, he asks me to dance, and I say, you'll regret it. I've got 2 left feet, so we're better off sitting. Well, I'm back at dancing, but good at drinking, so I keep to my seat here under the neon. I've got no good reason to be on my feet when I'm bad at dancing, but good at drinking. Sad old country songs I keep drinking them in, while my busted old two-step keeps keeping me sitting. 3/4 time with a fiddle and steel, one more drink, barkeep, put it on my bill. At dancing, but good at drinking, so I keep to my seat here under the neon. I
got no good reason to be on my feet when I'm bad at dancing but good at drinking. Basking in the honky tonk lights, killing my liver each sad, lonely night, while all the young lovers whirl round in the glow, living the music as they put on the show. To be on my feet when I'm bad at dancing, but good at speaking. Well, I got no good reason to be on my feet when I'm bad at dancing, but so good at drinking.
Stacey Bell.
I'm going to be at East by Two Goats on November 21st playing a solo set. So y'all should drop by. There's going to be six or seven artists showing their work.
And two goats.
And two goats. Yes, actually, literally two goats. There are two goats that run around the place, and everybody gets to play with the goats.
That sounds great.
It's fun. Thanks, y'all.
Thank you, Stacey.
You're still plugged in, Stacey.
Oh, you're plugged
don't
in.
Don't take
you're
your cord, Stacey.
You're still plugged
you're
in.
You're plugged in.
Thank you. She's gonna take it with.
Let's flip it around, Guy. You want to kick off?
Yeah, sure.
We start.
We were talking a little bit earlier about, I guess,
the disadvantaged population, and this is a song that I wrote. About the camping ban, specifically. I mean, I understand that people don't always like to, you know, see everybody camping by the side of the highways and stuff like that, because it's hard. You know, you don't want to see it. You just don't want to see it. I don't wanna look at that. But, you know, the flip side of that is much, much worse. You know, so it's just something to think about.
Let me lay down. My feet ache from all this walking around. I've been looking for a friend, but the law was all I found. Let me lay down. Let me lay down. The longest day on earth, changing my fortune, trying to prove my worth. A shit shower of shame, I'd be shining like a diamond, but it's rough, it ain't enough. 40 winks away from the man I need to be. Shelters are awful, except 110 miles.
day on my feet, and it's a night on the street. Let me lay down, let me lay down, let me lay down. I know no one round here wants me here round. I've been searching for my place, but I fear it has been found. Let me lay down, let me lay down. Staring at that screen until your day winds up this way. Let me lay down, let me lay down, let me lay down. I know no one round here wants me here round. I've been searching for my place, but I fear it has been found. Let me lay down. Let me lay
song written with Mr. Plankenhorn.
Oh, cool.
Very nice. What do you say, Profeska?
I'm going to try and sing a song. I learned it 1 a.m. last night.
Ooh, nice.
It'll go great, I'm sure, right?
Yes, it will.
It always does.
We played a gig, and I had a drink of wine or two, and went in the garage. He went to bed. It's like 1 a.m, and I come running into the bedroom. You have to hear the song. I learned it. Our house is exciting.
I don't remember any of that.
Yeah, you do. So this song, I want to send out to my Papa Jim. He's not with us anymore, but he loved this song. And forgive me if I mess it up. Oh.
Suffering and shame, and I love that old cross where the dearest and best world of lost sinners were slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies and last. Thank you.
walk around. To the old rugged cross, so despised by the world, it's a wondrous attraction for me. For the dear Lamb of God left his glory above to bear it to die.
Little wine rehearsal never hurt anybody.
Yeah, this will make my grandma really happy. My grandmother, my dad, and my uncle are all Pentecostal preachers. And wow. So I've been told my whole life that I'm anointed by the Holy Spirit, and I'm using my gift for the wrong thing. So maybe this will make my Mimi feel super proud of me.
You know it will.
I'm like, Mimi, I'm preaching kind of.
Yeah. She wants to come. You'll all have to conceal your drinks if that happens.
Really?
Yeah. Tell her that it's orange juice. She once got very drunk off of that carbonated grape juice that comes in like a wine bottle.
Oh, yeah. It's just like she convinced herself.
Yeah. I gave her like some sparkling grape juice and she was like,
She's awesome. She looks like Dolly Parton. She's sassy. We're going to bring her here and make her sing at you.
Is she currently preaching?
Yeah, she's a 85-year-old Pentecostal preacher that doesn't follow the rules and wears all the makeup.
All right.
It's my grandma.
Grew up as a sharecropper.
Yeah.
Grew up picking cotton.
That was the way it was for many a folk.
Time before Amazon.
Oh, mercy. Magdalene, Magdalene, favorite of the Nazarene. These days it's a different scene. Things got stupid, things got mean. All alone on the shore, wonder what I'm waiting for. Someone said we go on soon. Someone said to get in tune. I'm thinking about my old friend. Wouldn't bow, he wouldn't bend. But he wasn't hurting anyone. He was tough without a gun. Magdalene, oh Magdalene, favorite of the Nazarene. These days it's a different scene. Things got stupid, things got mean. Remember when we could get lost? How many made up lines we crossed? What a sweet and simple bond that kept us moving towards beyond. Her eyes in the morning sun promised love for everyone to rest your weary mind upon. Steal your heart and travel on. The highway where the brave can ride, instant cool, side by side. I wish that I'd have tried to hear more magic whispered in my ear. Sinking ship, your sacred name stays on my lips. The only song I've learned to sing, perfect as a broken wing. Magdalene, Magdalene, favorite of the Nazarene. These days it's a different scene. Things get stupid, things got mean. Magdalene, oh Magdalene, favorite of the Nazarene. These days it's a different scene. Things got stupid, things got mean. Yeah. Thanks so much. I appreciate it. Thank you. Nice. Uh-oh. Camera down.
Camera down.
Olympus has fallen.
Broken arrow.
The eagle has landed and then taken off again. All right.
What you got there?
Is it me?
Yeah, we're flipping it around.
We're flipping the script. Script flipping.
Script flipping.
That's such a pretty song. I'm still on that last song.
Thank you so much. Yeah, thank you.
I think that's the fourth time I've heard you sing it, and it gets...
It's getting better.
Thank you, man.
Not because you're getting better, but the more I go into it, the better it gets.
Well, thanks, man. Yeah.
That's many layers.
That is my song, yeah.
But who can really own it? I mean,
yeah.
And speaking of who can own music, we do have some CDs over there that us musicians tote about that we would hope then you will tote about.
Right. They really make your home look cool.
Yeah.
If you leave some CDs just lying about, it's, you know, it signals that willing to compromise, and you haven't turned over all control to the masters of the cloud. And so
use them as coasters.
Yeah, if you hang them up, it will scare mosquitoes.
Or maybe this winter, when the electricity goes out, you can have a battery-operated CD player and play music you own.
I believe in you. I have seen your light, and I know this is true. The world hasn't seen the gifts you bring with you. What you'll do, I believe in you. My faith is strong. It has brought me here, and if the road gets long, I will have no fear as the night comes on. I'll sing your song, my faith is strong. Trouble seems to find a way to steal the colors from the day, the moment that the sky turns gray and fades. I wonder, did I miss the sign? Nowhere to go at closing time. Just rattle off another rhyme and leave it on the stage. But I believe in you. I heard 1,000 stories. They all came true. It's in the little things you always do. When you come through, I believe in you. There are different kinds of despair, the most common of them being where you just deny the whole affair, pretend it doesn't smart. That taste I had so long ago, I wonder, do I even know the reason why I had to go? The dictates of my heart, but I believe. I have seen your light, and I know this is true. The world hasn't seen the gifts you bring with you. What you'll do, I believe in you.
Yeah. You want to take us on home? Thank you so much. Thank you very much for being here. Thanks to all of our guests. And we'll be ramping it on up towards the Gospel Turkeys, so tell all your friends.
GT.
The GT. The goat.
The GT.
The GT. And Professor Jessica is going to take us on home with a song by the name of
Never Talk to Strangers. It's a really good thing to keep in mind. This has been really fun. This is my first gospel brunch to be up here the whole time, so thanks. Yeah. I'll be playing the part of Bette Midler and his Tom Waits.
Stop me if you've heard this one, but I feel as though we've met before. Perhaps I am mistaken.
Oh, perhaps I just remind you of someone you used to care about. That was long ago. Tell me, did you think I'd fall for that old lie? Wasn't born just yesterday. I never talk to strangers anyway.
I ain't a bad guy when you get to know me. I just thought there ain't no harm.
Yeah, yeah. How about minding your own business, boy? Who asked you to annoy me with your sad, sad repartee? I never talk to strangers anyway. Your life's a dime store novel. This town is full of guys like you.
Oh, that's cool.
And you're
must be reading my mail. You better, cause he left you. That's why you're drinking in this bar. But only suckers fall in love with perfect strangers.
You know it takes one to know a stranger.
Maybe we are just wiser now.
Yeah. Been around the block so many times
that we don't notice that we're all just perfect strangers. Long as we know that we all begin as strangers just before we find we're
so much. We will see you next Sunday.
Scrappy Judd.